Here's Qwen Image Edit 2509 generating images locally on my RTX 3060 in only 42 seconds. In this video, I'm going to share the exact steps so you can do this too. So first up, you'll want to have Nunchaku installed onto your machine, and this is available for either Linux or Windows users. I'll put a link to this repository in the description, but basically scroll down about halfway or so to the installation guide and click on this, and it'll walk you through a few different ways that you can install it. So you can install it using pre-built wheels, and you can see all the steps here. Now, this is the approach that I took, and I did run into a few errors, and I found that Claude was helpful in diagnosing those errors and getting it up and running correctly. And of course, if you have ComfyUI installed onto your machine as a portable package, you can actually run simply a workflow and it will set it up for you. So you can then drag and drop this install wheel.json workflow onto Comfy and just simply run the workflow. Next up is to install the appropriate custom nodes. So in ComfyUI, go over to the Manager and Custom Nodes Manager, and then search up ComfyUI Nunchaku, and install this custom node and then reboot ComfyUI. I'll put a link to this custom node also in the description of this video. Lastly, you'll want to download the appropriate model files. So over on Hugging Face on the Nunchaku Qwen Image Edit 2509 repository, you'll see all the files available. So you can see that they have the R32 Qwen Image Edit 2509 Lightning 4-step model along with the Lightning 8-step model. Those are going to be the two that we look at. Now, the other ones offer better quality, but do run a little slower. So simply head over to the Files and Versions and download that appropriate model file. So we'll be taking a look at both of these model files right here. Once you download them, you'll want to place them into the Diffusion Models directory within ComfyUI. To get the appropriate text encoder and VAE, you'll just want to head over to the Qwen Image ComfyUI repository as well. Go over to the split files and you'll find the VAE here and place that into the VAE directory on ComfyUI. And then for the text encoders, you'll want to download this Qwen 2.5 VL7B FP8 scaled model and put this into the text encoder directory. Okay, we're almost ready to go. Now, if you head over to GitHub to the custom node we installed earlier and go to the example workflows, you'll see that they actually have a Qwen Image Edit 2509 Lightning workflow. So we're going to use that. Just simply download this file and then drag it onto the ComfyUI workspace. All right, so now that all of that is set up, let's start to generate an image. So we'll just want to make sure that we have the appropriate models loaded here. So I'm going to use the Lightning 4-step as an example first here. I'm going to leave everything else at the default. We have our clip, which is this Qwen 2.5 model. And then for the VAE, we have the Qwen Image VAE. So just like the Qwen Image Edit workflow, this is very similar. Just a few things have changed. I'm going to bypass this last node and then upload a couple of images that I'm going to prompt together. All right, so those images are uploaded and let's set the prompt. So I'm going to have the man in image one and the woman in image two sit together in a modern coffee shop in New York City and use a warm tone in the image. As you can see in this case sampler, the steps are set to 4 and the CFG is at 1 with an Euler sampler and a simple scheduler. So let's cue the workflow. So after only 43 seconds, we have our output image. So let's take a look at it. As you can see, it looks great. This was all done on an RTX 3060. We have both the man and the woman with the same likeness now sitting in a coffee shop in New York City. Awesome. All right, so let's try this out with the 8-step model now. So to do that, I'm going to use a fixed seed value just to kind of see a difference in the outputs, but change the steps over to 8 and then change the model here to the 8-step model and leave everything else the same. So let's run this workflow, see how long it takes, and compare the output images. And after a minute and 26 seconds and 8 steps, we have our output as we can see it here. The image itself looks pretty darn good. And just to quickly compare it to that 4-step image, here's what the 4-step image looked like, and here's what that 8-step image looks like. Both of them look, I think, phenomenal. Maybe there's an argument that the 8-step model is a little bit better, which, you know, would make sense given that it has a few more steps to it. It looks like it's got a little bit better on the details, but the 4-step model still looks pretty darn good. So that's it with running Qwen Image Edit 2509 locally and only in RTX 3060. This little beast of a GPU still lives on. If you have any questions, drop it in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.